So if you can have that handy, and you can sit in Virasana or Sukhasana. So Virasana, hero pose, is the shins. We'll get to it anyway, but later. And Sukhasana is crossing your shins. Mid shin, toes flexed, sitting bones able to ground. And if not, you can take your towel roll, sidle to one side, sidle to the other, and create a little seat. I like to make a little horseshoe and create a seat. Closing the eyes and feel the outer hips, sit bones descend. And then bring the breath into the body, which seems or sounds silly to say, but what I mean is to bring your awareness of breath into your body. Feeling the dark spaces, feeling those that are readily accessible. The front of the body, the back of the body, the sides, the outer hips, tracing a line to the inside of the armpits, the front of the throat, the back of the throat, the cavern of the eyes, the cavity of the eyes, the sides of the skull, around the ears, and the cords of the neck, transitioning down from behind the ears to the shoulders, transitioning down the triceps of the upper arms, the backs of the arms. Bringing the breath, the awareness into the belly, the inner legs, releasing tension in the psoas, kidneys, low back. And so we could continue on if we were doing this somatic awareness exercise. And eventually, given time and skill, we could open up the body without even moving. It's starting to happen for me now as I release these points of awareness. But step one is to identify these points in the body and then release tension, holding. So how you hold yourself literally is a reflection of your awareness and how you're reacting to what's happening around you. So in the end, it is truly all about you. But let's open the eyes and bring the palms to the heart. Inhaling, we'll take an om where you can just hum. Om. These hands. Then from here, let's take a simple twist to the left, hooking the right hand on the left knee. Left fingertips behind you. Float the heart up. Broaden the collarbones. So a point of awareness initially in the front of the body floating, and then exhale, point of awareness down the big hips, the low back as you press down into the ground. And so in a yoga pose, it's in a way a form of meditation or a form into which we could breathe. And meditation sounds like a big word for some, but it's really just known as dharana, which is just focusing. So many of you are athletes or former athletes, so what is the form of this pose and how can we keep our eyes closed and just breathing here. Bring the breath into the form. almost like pouring the breath into the form. And let's reach the left arm up and start to lean over. So of course I come up with these rather silly secular images, and I'm thinking of the 1950s Jell-O molds. And I think my mother actually had one, pouring the Jell-O mix into the mold and then it congeals. So we pour our breath into the body in this form, and of course it's not so much hardening, but it's gaining integrity across all the planes of awareness. And let's lift up to vertical across the left arm over the right, commit to Garuda Asana, or just take the hands to the shoulders. Float the elbows up to shoulder height, and then the counteraction is to glide the elbows downward as if you are pressing into a countertop. Again, you take 5 or 6 breaths here, either static, feeling the spread of the shoulder blades is your point of awareness in the back of the body. Or you can bring some movement, gliding elbows up on inhale and down on exhale. So since we are working with our morning bodies, most of us, we move into it slowly. Not only for the sake of the body, release, rotate, right? Take the other side of the twist. But also to play with this concept this morning that yoga is more than just stretching. So I find the form, how it looks is not super important. But if you close your eyes, notice breath coming in and out, and spread your awareness. So where is the first point you go to? Well, maybe it's an injured part of the body or somewhere that's tight, and you can work with that knot, K-N-O-T, or you can just spread, like spreading butter on toast, the breath around the body and try to find an evenness. And then releasing that, moving to the next form, reaching up right arm and leaning left. So yes, I'm trying to lengthen this upper arm, but if all of my awareness and effort go into that, what's happening in the dark side, so to speak, the shadow side of the left ribs that I'm leaning down into, are they somehow collapsing, or can I find an evenness? And how are the hips? Are they solid to the earth? Inhale, vertical, cross diagonally over the left arm. Take your wrap or take your hands to your shoulders. Lift up the elbows and then set them on an imaginary countertop. Head is slightly dropped, forehead, as if you're going to rest your head into your upper arms. And you're getting a little stretch. Sure, I could focus your attention on the right triceps, rhomboid. But once you get beyond that, can you spread your awareness through the form? Again, the Jell-O, gelatin style of yoga, and create evenness. And then inhale, lift, exhale. And this is known as, or in Sanskrit, we call it sama, like same. Can we create sameness? Not so much boring sameness, but evenness of awareness. And then releasing that, and let's spin around. Let's do a little body rolling with our roll. Let's take it to the low shoulder blade level. And we're gonna lay on it, on our backs.
We just had Garuda Asana with the protraction, moving a part of the shoulder blades. So if you take your shoulder blade tips to the blade gap, open your arms either straight out or goalpost. Now we're gonna reverse that pattern, and we have a little retraction a little drawing together of the shoulder blade tips, but not much. Make sure your head is comfortable. And then exhale, drop the knees to the left, keeping the feet wide. And go back and forth. So now we'll roll on that space, that fascia just below the shoulder blades, because we are going to do some twists. And it's always a good idea to create some spirals in the morning body. The head can go the other way. And most of you in coming to class know that you can start to push on the diagonal with the upper knee. So if the legs or knees go to the left, I can push with the right foot, right knee heads on the diagonal to the back left corner of my mat. My left hip may come off the ground. And then let's come back to center and take our arms up to the sky like we're reaching for a cloud. And we'll grab the right wrist and just start to pull the right arm a little longer and pull it over to the left, looking to the left. Once again, protraction, but who cares? Don't take your, or rob your body of the total experience. Come back to center and grab that right wrist and just start to gently pull. So where are you bringing your attention? And I'm helping, I'm adjusting your awareness in your body, which could be good, but it also could be unfortunate because then you don't have your own experience. So it's a fine balance teaching, of course, and I'm already getting too philosophical on a Friday, but let's take our arms out to goalposts, straighten our legs. And then we'll bend the knees and take bridge pose. You put the elbows on the towel roll. Inhale, spread open the chest as we just had it. Exhale, lift the hips up. And just come up and down. And the exhale pattern allows you to experience this mild back bend. And maybe the head even rolls back. You can push down into the towel roll with your elbows and keeping the elbows close to the rib cage. Exhale, you release and the head rolls back into back bend. Let's come up and take our hands to slide the towel roll. You might need to roll over to do this, to the sacrum, and pull the knees into the body. So the most readily accessible point of awareness is, of course, where the low back meets the towel roll, maybe. And we pull the knees in toward us and glide them away and just start to move and open the dorsal sheet, the back body, the low back fascia. And then let's hold the left knee and extend the right leg forward. I'm working against a wall, but you don't have to. You have the wall, you can push into it, and then just upswing. So draw the left knee toward you, exhale, release it away. So where is your point of awareness and how is the quality of your breath now? And how's that left hip feeling as you start to make circles? We do it, we've done many, many times. Both directions. And so I'm doing some repetition so that on your days off or years from now, when you're traveling, you can just have some tools, some basic tools. And then can you hold that left knee with the left hand, reach your right arm up to the sky, and then back beyond you. Extend your breath, your inhale, into the right side, the right leg and the right arm expanding like they have helium. Exhale, left knee goes out to the side. Take a few breaths. So where's your attention now? Yeah, there might be a little bit of core happening, a little bit of opening of that right armpit subscap. and then reach back up to the sky with the right arm, bring the left knee to the midline, grab it with the right hand, just give it a little pull over to the right. Figure four, you can just drag your right knee behind that left ankle, set it up and pull it toward you, still on the towel roll as you bind the left arm through the legs, the right hand around. So both hands are on the right shin. And you can point and flex the right foot, toes, make little circles of the right foot, and then push and pull the figure four toward you. Extra credit. Straighten the right leg and bind the back of it, advanced students. And if you've done a lot of yoga, I think Barbara Butterworth is here, Ashtanga, you could even go back to your Ashtanga days and pull the right foot into the belly and take a half lotus, making sure the knees are even. The rest of us in figure four, as we drop it down to the floor, uncross, and take the right knee into both hands, extend the left leg. And then moving slowly, just gliding the right knee toward us, away from us, and not locking the tool of the breath. I don't spend a lot of time talking about yogic methods of breath, but those that know Ujjayi Pranayama, the sound of the ocean, the slight contraction of the throat to create almost the sonar ocean sound in the back of the throat is useful. Little circles. And how's the, how you doing with the points of awareness? In a way, stiffness, injury, and soreness are, could be thought of as boons or blessings because they allow you to experience your body. And one day you may wake up and not be able to feel a human body anymore, and you might not have one. Who knows? That's another question for later on. And then let's hold the right shin and the left arm comes up and back. So I've been reading Tolstoy, and so he's speculating that the carnal body, the physical body, is only a brief blip in your life cycle. You're still existing before and after. And let's peel that right knee out to the side. But right now we've got these bodies to deal with. And then we'll pull the right knee to the center, grab it with the left hand, draw it over to the side, and lay the right. Then figure four, right ankle cross left knee, draw in the package toward you, and you can have the value of the towel roll to spread up in the low back, and point and flex the left toes, little circles, and then push and pull the figure four toward and away. Extra credit. Straighten the left leg and bind the back of it, pushing it into your bind. So the left leg is fully straight to the sky. Old school Ashtangis can even take your hands and pull your right foot into your belly for a half lotus and try that out, evening the knees. And then the most people will release the figure four, but the people that were doing the Ashtanga move could take a full lotus on your towel roll and pull it in toward you, and then hold the toes and move it away. Go easy. Big move for the hip flexors. Okay, so let's release the feet down, lift the towel roll up, wide the legs long, take a breath. And let's grab the towel roll now and do a little bit more with the arms, reaching our trapeze towel up to the sky and toning the backs of the legs to the ground. As you inhale, glide the towel roll back behind you. And then exhale back up to the sky and repeat. Now, can you bring the core a little bit into it by pulling the right knee toward you and tapping it with the towel as the arms come forward? Kick the right leg back to where it was on the floor, towel back, and left knee comes in and tap. So we're just going for a little walk. And I want you to try and monitor across the spot where we just had the towel roll a minute ago. In the low back, as we move in asymmetry here. Next time your right knee comes up, we're going to sling our towel roll behind the knee. A little tricky move. So just lift the leg a little and then squish the towel, roll behind the right knee, hold the ends of the towel in your hands, and inhale, glide the right knee toward your right shoulder, exhale, kick away. And as you glide the right knee and squish, this is for Doreen, I think she's here, for your, and maybe Alvaro if he's here, for the knees, anyone with knee problems. So we squish the towel roll in that right knee as it gets drawn toward us, and then glide it away. And then eventually, when we glide that right leg away, we kick it up to the sky, and push the back of the knee into the towel roll. Let's try the other side. And we're gonna pull the left knee in, sling the towel roll around the back of the left knee. A little tricky, but use your cowboy skills from your past life as an Argentinian gaucho or Western cowboy. And of course, Lisa has the up and up on that, being in Montana. But now we're just gonna make a little knee sandwich. The towel roll gets squished behind the knee capsule as we pull with our arms, left knee toward the left shoulder, and then we start to just release the leg away and squish. So actively squish that towel roll, and then we're starting to extend and kick the left leg to straight up to the sky, push gently into the back of the knee now with a straight leg. And then release. Take the legs long, arms by the sides for a second, just feel points of awareness. And then can we pull the right knee in and flip the towel around the right foot and extend it up to the sky. Now, same thing, inhale, pull right knee toward right shoulder and push to straight leg, but now we've got the awareness on the sole of the foot. If it's too much to extend the leg using your towel, you can abandon the towel and fish around for your strap. But if you can, straighten the right leg and gather both towel ends, the right hand, and you guessed, the right leg goes out to the side, left arm opposite. I like to use my right elbow as a kickstand on the ground. And fill the awareness through both legs from the belly outward toward the soles of the feet. So from proximal to distal. Now the right leg comes up, we grab the towel ends with the left hand, take the leg a little over to the right, stretch the IT, and don't get caught up in the stretch too much. Again, that's stretching. Yoga is, okay, I'm in a form, how does the entire body respond to this? As if I were meditating. Come back to center, we're gonna lasso up the left foot, the towel and extend it. So hopefully you've now felt the connection of the back of the knee to the sole of the foot. As you bend the left knee, pulling on the towel roll ends, and then straighten. So opening up the back of the knee, opening up the fascia of the foot, go together. And we're gonna grab the towel roll, the left hand, and out goes the left leg to your degree of ability. But instead of pushing again into a stretch, can you move the left hip out toward the foot? Move your awareness. Since we started in the hip capsule anyway, we move through the knee and into the foot. Now I'm making these points of awareness as we hold the towel roll ends in the right hand and glide the straightened left leg just, oh, maybe 6 inches, 2 feet to the right. And instead of trying to drive that left leg to the ground like we did in our 20s, can we move from the left hip through the left knee through the foot from proximal or near to the body to distal away? Really good, then let's release that for a second. Feel the body, feel the points of awareness. Should be getting warmer. And then can we pull the knees in and throw the towel? You can see I'm doing this little and sandwich both knees. And you can hug the knees and squish the towel and point the toes away from you, so dorsal flex. So here's Virasana, right? You can even take the arms back to the floor and see if you can just hover here. The arms reaching all the way back, the shins hugging the towel. And then can you make little circles on your low back, like moving the knees to the left and then forward, and little back rub. And I'm tricking you into core. Forward and back. And then reach the arms up to the sky, grab the ends of the towel and straighten both legs, pushing the backs of the legs right behind the knees, maybe a little below, as you straighten, look at your toes. Bend the knees again, release the towel. One more, we take the towel roll into our bellies and pull the knees in and squish it into our belly, Uddiyana Bandha. And then can we float the shins parallel to the floor and reach the arms back toward the floor beyond us and just hover here. Reach to the sky with the arms like you're grabbing a box, and then exhale, arms staying parallel, go to the right 6 inches. You can look toward the space and the knees go left. Inhale to center and just pivot. But the towel, which is resting on your belly, is giving you some information of drawing the transverse abdominals across the belly, engaging them. And then can we take the arms back again? And start to straighten the legs. Look at the toes, flex them back toward you, lengthen the back and the knee to the sole of the foot, and slowly start to push the feet just 6 inches forward. Now you're in downward dog. But the belly's laying, the towels are laying on your belly, and think of ingesting the towel into the low belly to lengthen the low back, which may have gone into a bit of curvature. So this is a strength move, the quads are engaging. Then you bend the knees, set the hips down, and lift the hips up to bridge pose. Towel might still be on your belly. You can slide your shoulder blades underneath so that you don't just push the hip flexors up. Feel the, or imagine the weight or the suggestion of the towel as the countermeasure to thrusting the hips forward. Come down, release the towel. Again, roll the knees left and right as we did earlier. And then roll off to one side and come up to seated. or hands and knees rather. So have your towel roll handy and we'll do our daily scrubbing. And fold the mat to create a platform for the knees and then scrub forward and pull back. So advance cat and cow. Now as you do this, I want you to feel, if you can, everything you can, but we've worked on certain places, the last one being this placement of the towel roll into the low belly. And so that's still in play as we extend forward, Uddiyana Bandhas, it's called upward lifting belly, is holding us safe. Then if you come back to Virasana and pull that towel roll right into your belly, drop your head, you'll feel the experience of it. And then release. Unfurl your mat. And we'll take the towel roll down and place the hip flexors with the tops of the legs, easy cobra, and come up on our forearms. Then we can roll from the one side to the other, left to right, to open up the hip flexors. And some people can pull the knee opposite of the side we roll toward them. We've done in the past. And look at it, and you get a little more juice in the hip flexor. A little crawling action. And then place the head down on top of the hands. Allow the legs to relax for a second. Then slide the head down to the floor and take the hands back to a cobra position and lift up halfway to cobra and feel the chest opening but the backs of the legs toning, tailbone lengthening. And then we'll press back to child's pose. We can take our foreheads and elbows to the towel roll. Come up to hands and knees, and then see if you can sit back in Virasana again. Take that towel roll into your belly. Now we'll try the Uddiyana Bandha test. So can you sandwich that towel roll, tuck your toes under, and drop your head to prepare for down dog? Pulling the towel roll back, can you feel the back of the knee coming into its folded pattern? The back of the soles of the feet opening. And then we're going to open up the back of the knee. We're going to open up the entire back of the leg by pulling into our bellies and seeing if we can keep the towel roll. Even if the knees are bent in our bellies, look back at the feet, extend the arms. And then you can drop the towel roll down and bring your knees down on top of it. So now we're in Virasana with the towel roll in front of our knees, and we can roll out the anterior tibialis. So the little muscles along the shin bone. If you get a toe cramp, you can push down into your out to your feet. Get a little reflexology. Really good. And then we'll take the towel roll off and take the toes under toes pose. We'll take the towel roll, this is a full roll of the body, to just behind the feet. And with the toes tucked under and plantar flexion, it may be a little hard for some of you. You can lean forward, modify. And then we're going to take the hands down, hands and knees. Come to a down dog stomping on our towel roll, like we're stomping up grapes. And now feel the soles of the feet, the backs of the knees, the belly lifting all in tandem. Everything's working together to create points of awareness and so that the legs can begin to balloon out and expand. Take your toes out like a duck on your towel roll and walk your hands back. Squat on the towel in Malasana. See if that's possible. And you can move from here to forward fold a few times, spiraling your toes to parallel. And then plie out and sink down at your leisure. Fingertips down, legs. Feeling those points of the soles of the feet, the backs of the knees. Even the Uddiyana Bandha that we just worked on. One more, and then we're mostly done. Come down onto your knees. Again, collect your towel roll and lift up with your hips forward. And just drop that towel behind the knees. Scoop it in there. And let's sit back. Hands forward, and then this is for only a few. We're going to come up with the towel roll squished behind the knees on the calves, and we're on our toe mounds. And so now we're finding those points of connection, soles of feet, knees, Uddiyana Bandha, and it's possible to balance. So when you get it, it's super fun because you realize you've connected the dots. Come down, release, take that away. Now let's see what we've got. Downward dog, should feel good. Let's bring the feet together, lift the right leg back. Here against the wall, you can push into it. And then knee to nose. Back and forth, extend, and knee to nose. Now this time, we're gonna come with the right knee forward and come down on that right shin. Kick the left toes back. This is Ardha Vajrasana. Should be Ardha Virasana, but we're gonna sit on that folded right knee. So some of you might want a little support of your left hip flexor by doubling the towel. Now we're gonna try to come down into our forearms. And those that can, we're gonna reach your, or spiral your chest a little bit to the right, and reach your right arm back along the right side. Just try to balance. So I've created a synchronicity of the right belly pulling in, right knee, and I rotate. Left arm stretches forward, right arm back, and then release. Let's try the other side. Come back to down dog and lift the left leg, pushing you to the wall if you have it. When you're ready, knee to nose a few times. And we've had a towel roll behind the knee, so we should feel more readily what it means to collect the knee in. And then you come toward high plank and set the left shin down, kick the right toes back, and you just start to test it out, coming down with this attenuation of the left lower belly, the knee. Maybe your head gets to the ground, maybe not. Maybe you can just walk your hands on a diagonal to the left and see what I'm doing with my left hand back, my right arm forward, and I'm scooping
into the left belly.
And then we'll come back to downward dog. Take a breath. And then when you're ready, step the feet to the hands. Bring your hands up to your shins and lengthen your spine. And while you're down there, take a forward fold and find your towel roll again. One more. Bend your knees and bring the towel roll up.
Good. And now, the final one. And now that's where I do my Ed Sullivan imitation, this really big shoe, is I take what's called Jalabhar Bandha. So what's this all about?
You don't want to jam the chin down, but we have a banda here. So you could think of a banda as a connection point. Oh, and then one more, we take the towel behind us and we take it up, squish it like a penguin in our armpits. Tone our legs. We've got the Ed Sullivan Show. And now you've got a perfect Tadasana Mountain Pose. You don't need that anymore, but now you're standing like a yogi and you can walk around all day being very stiff. Or you can glide your right toes back, balance on your left leg, and reach to the sky. Inhale, exhale, open the arms. So where are the points of awareness now? Well, we're externally rotating the upper arms. And let's make a figure, go pose figure. Inhale, open and lift the chest. Ah, and then close the forearms and open and close. Now we're moving into the upper realms. Having opened the hips, the knees, maybe a little bit of the low back. Can we bring the knee technology into the closing of the arms? Bring the right knee up and like we're collecting a towel under this knee. Could do whatever I want here with this leg depending on ability. But the basic motion now, we're uniting these banda points here, here, here. Advanced students are already pretty open. They're just like, well, I could just, I don't care what Dan's doing, he's not watching me, right? But the basic for the students that are new is to now play with how these lower bandas are now connecting with the arms. Let's step back, warrior one, airplane, right foot down, and launch the pose. So where's your awareness now? Can you feel the back of the right knee, the sole of the right foot, the belly, Uddiyana Bandha, then open the arms like Atlas. Put the chest open, and then goal post. And then close the arms. Brush the front knee, airplane, lean forward. Step the right foot to the left. Chair pose, inhale. Exhale, leg straighten, bring the palms to the heart. So all these little loops, and instead of squishing a towel, you can think, you know, an eddy in a river? Same thing with the armpits, there's little circles. And then we take the arms up and out, and the left toes go back. And we create uniformity. So rather than getting all jangly in the anatomy, if I wore a hood ornament on a Mercedes, and then we goal post, it's a little less stretch on the poor pec minors, and we start to open and close. So this is the beginner movement. But then the left knee could come up, and it has in its awareness, its consciousness, the memory of the towel roll squeezed behind the knee, which allows incredible strength for those that are experienced to play any sorts of games with the leg beyond the simple motion. Oh. So I'm leaving that up to you and your ability level, but I've given you the touchstones. One more. We close, lean forward, curl, airplane, and step back, the left foot to warrior one. Sink the hips, bring the arms up, ah, and then open. More like seagull wings here than trying to lock the joints. Go post, inhale, exhale, wrap. Brush the front knee, airplane, lean. Step the back foot to the front, both knees are bent. Inhale, chair. And stand. Really good. And now can we move on to the warrior twos using technology
of the joints. So there are these things called bandas. I've been referencing binds. It's a loose translation. And David Svensson, who's a big Ashtangi, let's take our left arm up only, right hand at the hip, right foot back. And then closing on the diagonal, like you're going to touch your left elbow to the right knee. So David Svensson would say they're more like locks in a canal system. So they allow the energy of the body to open and close. Here's the closed pattern, here's the open pattern. And again, experienced people are saying, well, that's nice, Dan. I could just hook my left hand on my knee and reach back, take a yoga pose. But we don't really care what transpires. We want the primary points of awareness. So I'm turning you loose into your own body. Oh. And then we find the coil. We step back with the right foot. But this time, we're in the side plane of warrior two. Back foot's at 90. Sink the hips down. Reverse warrior, right hand down the back leg, left arm up. Sink into the front hip. And then we place the forearm down, or if you were to go all the way to the ground, fine. But remember the sensation of the towel roll in that left belly. So even if you were to take your, if you want, just take the pose, but if you square off, take your right hand to your left gut and just wedge it in there. And pull energetically back. And then up you come and throw the discus. So, but still in this left belly, I'm pulling back and scooping that left pelvic calf under to prevent misery in the hip. Inhale, come up, open the legs and the arms, hinge that same point right here in the left belly. Take the left hand to the shin, look around. And then from that lock, I have freedom to move. Trikonasana. Inhale, come up, square off, and lift the back heel. Lift the chest, and then like you're gonna touch the back knee down, and we'll do a few of these, which I do every day for strength in the back leg. Eventually find your low lunge, and if you need to double up the right side of the mat, you can. Or take your blanket roll. So make sure you're comfortable. And then hands to front knee and sink. So we have these points of awareness, and we have one behind this left knee. So as you sink forward, rather than just dumping everything, you have a little attenuation behind this left knee, this left belly, that allows you to reach up with your right arm and have a nice twist, because there's a little point here, there's a little point in the left belly, and they're not only folding, but they're collecting. You can imagine the blanket collected, but it's a volume. It's a volume, there's a back draw or retraction into those joints to keep them from being completely loose. And taking your twist to your measure, maybe it's a full lifting of the back knee. This is where you decide how it works. Then we start to go back, and we can go back and forth as beginners to lunge and straighten the left leg. Normally this is all we do. But experienced people can unfurl the right toes and maybe sit all the way back. This is for the advanced people with the right knee forward. And lean back. Or take a forward fold. Triang Mukaita Pada Pashimottanasana. And then coming forward, walking your hands forward, lifting your back knee, and launching up to standing split. So create an L with the legs. And then you have the option, advanced students, pushing down through the left heel, right hand to hip. Roll up in the right leg and take your half moon. So feel the backs of the knees, feel the belly, and the sole of the bottom foot. Come down, take a forward fold, and release. Then your knees come up to chair pose. I'm gonna shut off my monitor because I'm moving slow. Chair pose, and then standing. You have a towel, wayward, kick it out. So again, remember the arms drop, the Ed Sullivan show. Don't overdo it, but this is your, if you go to a structural class like Iyengar, they're gonna love you for having it. But let's take the left toes back, the right arm out like a wing, and then exhale, pull the opposite knee to elbow. Come across. Normally we'll be doing this on our back. Again, advanced students start to play. Well, I can hook my right hand across my left knee and rotate, maybe extend the left leg. So that's up to you, but once you have these primary connections, step back to warrior two, left foot. Open the arms. Reverse warrior. Now feel the soles of the feet, the backs of the knees, the belly, all attenuated, all conscious. And then as you come into side angle, you can take the modification or deeper. But if the left hand can scoop inside that right belly and pull the right hip, pelvic calf to the midline, by pulling the belly in, you're going to be safer as you launch the left arm up and over. So that right hip wings out. Trouble in River City. So the bandas are good, safe tools. And then we open the arms and the legs, triangle pose. And we're still, it's harder with a straightened front leg, we're still hinging down into that right hip and trying to move that sit bone right into the midline. You can have the front knee bent or not, you can have the hand on the chair, I don't care. But that little lock in the left or the right belly is gonna hold you off. Inhale coming up. And let's square off, lift the back heel, step in a little bit if you need to, hands to hips, up and down you go, dropping the left knee toward the mat. Even as you do this, what's going on in the right knee, the right belly? Are things going willy-nilly? Glide down and take your hands to your right knee. So even as you sink forward, just to show you the games that I play, I could be having a sense of retracting. So I'm balancing, attempting to, at 8:30 in the morning, just to show you the retraction that we played with earlier. Even as we lunge forward, there's a retraction, and that keeps us safe to reach up with the left arm, spiral and rotate. Even as I dive forward, if I'm an advanced student, into a deeper lunge, I have the sense of engagement back this way that we just did when we were going like this. So the knee was coming up. It was coming up to join the hand, and if both come together, you have the best of both worlds, and it actually helps lift you into a deeper pose. So I'm lifting up this leg toward me,
that creates a different pose. Come down when you're done with that, and we go back and forth, straightening the right leg. And we can once again see and feel the sole of the right foot, the back of the knee. This is what you stay with as a beginner. Advanced students, or those without knee problems, could sit all the way back. This is a yoga pose called three points facing west and take the pose. Primarily for Barbara, who's in Ashtangi, who may be missing that pose. The rest of the mortals come back, set up your standing split with the fingers forward or using the chair. Launch the L shape of the left leg, look down. Any variations of holding the right heel with one or both hands, fine. And then flat back, and you can come into half moon. Right hand is in front of the right foot, now to the side. You engage the awareness in the left leg as the toes turn out to the left. Maybe the left arm comes up. And don't come all up into your throat, but engaging the hip points, frontal hip points, back of the knee, sole of the left foot. Are those all lit up? And then you come down to forward fold, shake it loose. Walk your hands under your feet, Hastasana. Bend your knees and flatten your back like a ski jumper, lengthening the back of the neck. In the bent knee position now, you have your sensation of the towel roll in the belly, and then you telescope the legs straight, you drop the head. You feel the backs of the knees, the soles of the feet, because the hands are under them. You can go back and forth here, bending and straightening. The armpits, when you get deep, also remember the sensation of having squeezed the towel roll in toward them, and they draw your chest deeper through. And what about that towel roll in the throat, Chalandara Bandha? As the weight travels forward, the chin is meeting the opening chest. Take the toes out like a duck, Malasana.
So all these things conspire in a good way to help us get deeper. Sadly, we've wasted an entire hour, as they used to say, on click and clack, the Tabitha Brothers here in Boston, car talk. And now we can take a simple forward fold, maybe with the towel under the knees. And see how that feels to push. And then if you're near a wall, we've done this one before, we're gonna use our towel roll as we started class. And watch first in a plat pose variation. We lift the hips, towel roll into the back, and pull the knees in, and then try to take the feet to the wall. Bring the towel roll a little deeper under the back, pull the legs, what have you. Take some breaths. Like to push into the wall and maybe take it deeper. And eventually allow the legs to go away from the wall and point up to the sky. And now you've set up a nice Viparina Karani. The elevated legs and the towel roll under the small of the back. And relax. So see if you can let the legs float. And the soles of the feet, the backs of the knees, all the points of awareness are in play without being too tense. Try to feel them just lit up like little sparkling, flashing lights. Eventually bending the knees, taking one foot, the other foot down, and taking the towel roll out to straighten and lengthen your legs, Shavasana. And just take a few breaths to release the arms, the legs, the belly, all the points that we've played with, maybe even taking the palms to the belly and giving it permission to release. And as we started class, breathing into the field of the body. Field like a garden. Field of awareness. And in the Bhagavad Gita, is a famous yoga text, actually. The field is called the field of Dharma, Buddhist fans. And so your body, your dharma, your duty, say you're a doctor, lawyer, Indian chief, artist, that's partly your dharma, what you've been designed to do, but your primary dharma exists in your physical body. So you're working with your physical body, as we did today, allows you to experience one of your primary duties in life. Bending the knees, roll to one side, letting the forehead rest, and come up seated. And we'll see how things feel now. We've made some awareness. Sure, maybe you're a little more refreshed and stretched out, so to speak. But what does that mean? So the breath is expanding your awareness in your body. So you have a little more consciousness in yourself, a little more, not so much control as awareness, and then you're better in your interactions in the space around you, the people around you.